Hi, everybody. Welcome. This is JoJo with Northwest Association for Blind Athletes. Thanks for joining us today for our secondary virtual PE lesson with Tara. As a reminder, you should always consult with your doctor before beginning any type of exercise or physical activity. You're responsible for your own health and safety at all times, and we encourage you to self-monitor throughout the workout, take breaks when needed, hydrate, and modify your activity based on you and your based on how you and your body are responding to this workout today. And as we always start with our programs, we'll start with our mission. The mission of Northwest Association for Blind Athletes is to provide life-changing opportunities through sports and physical activity to individuals who are blind and visually impaired. And we'll be doing that today by covering three standards. The first standard, number one, is the physically literate individual demonstrates competency in a variety of motor skills and movement patterns. So we'll be doing that with dance and Zumba. Our second standard is the physically literate individual demonstrates the knowledge and skills to achieve and maintain a health-enhancing level of physical activity and fitness. And finally, our third standard we'll be covering in our lesson today is the physically literate individual exhibits responsible personal and social behavior that respects self and others. So I will turn it over to Tara and we'll get started.
Thank you, JoJo. And so when we're doing this today, we are doing a modified version of Zumba. So we're going to do a little bit of dancing, but most of the moves are more exercise based so that those of us who are not natural born dancers like myself can still play along and get active while doing it. So as we start, we'll go through a warm up. We'll have three different songs that we'll do moves to, and then we'll have a cool down. Each of the songs that we're doing moves to, we're gonna make it simple. We have three moves that we're gonna do to each song, and we'll just repeat those three moves. And if at any time you get lost or you're thinking, oh, I don't know what move is next, we will have JoJo telling us when to switch moves along with the music. And then we also have the option if you get lost and you're like, I don't know what moves next, I don't know what's going on, you can just walk in place until you find your place again. So those are the options. So to start off for our warm up, we're just gonna walk in our space. So I am standing on a yoga mat today, and I'm just gonna walk back and forth on the yoga mat because it's time to just wake your body up. Maybe you're just sitting at a computer all day with all the virtual things that are going on. So just waking your body up, letting it know that you're about to get some exercising on. So we'll walk in place. We have a few other warm-ups, warm-up exercises, and then we'll get to the fun part of modified and adapted Zumba. I'm gonna walk back and forth a few times. If you wanna walk in place or if you have more space than I do on the mat and you have area to walk around wherever you're doing this from, feel free to do that. All right, and we're gonna come back to the center of your space, and I'm gonna stick my arms out to a T shape. So my left fingertips are pointed to the wall to my left. My right fingertips are pointed to the wall to my right, and we're gonna do arm circles. So I'm gonna roll my shoulders forward, and I'm gonna start with small circles. So pretend I'm drawing imaginary circles with the fingertips, my fingertips on each side. I'm gonna start with small circles, and you're gonna progressively make them a little bit bigger until you're making them as big as you're comfortable. And then maybe once you get as big as you're comfortable, you can find that happy medium where you liked it best. I like doing bigger medium circles best for my shoulders. And now we're going to switch directions. So get back into that T shape that we started in. And now we're going to go backwards. So roll your shoulders backwards, move your arms in the opposite direction, and still drawing those imaginary circles with your fingertips. Smaller circles, two bigger circles. And find the place in the circles that you liked. I like medium to big ones, so I'm gonna go back there. Alrighty, so now we're gonna go into high knees. So what you're going to do is lift up your left knee up to the ceiling. At the same time you do that, you're going to have your both arms in bent in a 90 degree angle. And when I bring my left knee up towards my chest or towards the ceiling, I'm gonna bring my right arm forward, bent in that 90 degree angle. And then I'll bring them down at the same time. And then when I lift my right knee up towards the ceiling, when I bring my knee up, it makes a bend in my leg, so my leg isn't straight. When I lift my right knee up, my left arm comes forward and back down. So I'm going to do high knees, and I'm gonna do this at a marching pace, and I'll progressively get a little bit faster. If you wanna jump into the faster ones, you're more than welcome to. And just do these at your own pace. If you wanna do them a little bit slower, do them slower. Best part about doing this online is that you get to go at your own pace. So that reminds me that if at any time you want to pause, you have the ability to pause the video and pick up where you left off, or maybe you need a water break in the middle, and you can do that. If you want to spend more time warming up or cooling down than you do, feel free to pause, hold stretches for longer. Maybe even do different warm-up or cool-down activities if you have ones that you like better or that serve your body better. Alrighty, I'm going to go into toe touches now. So I'm back in the center of my workout space. I'm gonna spread my feet wider than shoulder width apart. I'm gonna put my arms out in that T like we started with arm circles. I'm going to take my right hand, I'm gonna bend at my waist and bring my right hand to my left toe. And when I do that, my left arm goes way up to the ceiling. And then I'm gonna come back up into that T position. And then I'm gonna go back down and bring my left hand to my right foot, right hand to the ceiling, and then come back up. So we're going to repeat this motion. Because warm-ups are dynamic, so we repeat the movement, lengthening and shortening our muscles, waking them up, getting them ready for our awesome exercise slash dance moves. Let's do a few more of these toe touches. Call these windmill toe touches. And one, two. All right, and then we're gonna come back to standing and we're gonna do some core twists. So you can put your arms out to your sides, bend your elbows, whatever's comfortable for you. The most important part is that you keep your feet planted underneath your hips, maybe a little bit wider if that helps you balance a little bit better. And what you're gonna do is you're going to twist your core, so your shoulders and your arms and your core are gonna twist, but your hips and your legs and your feet are gonna stay in the same spot. So I'm gonna bring my right shoulder over to the front of where my body was facing before, my left shoulder to where it used to be behind my back. And I have a twist in my core, but my hips are still facing forward. And then I'm gonna untwist, face forward, and then I'm gonna bring my left shoulder towards the front of where my front used to be facing, then my back, my right shoulder is now behind where my back used to be. And then I'm gonna untwist. So I'm just gonna keep going back and forth, twisting, trying really hard to keep my hips where they are and getting those core twists in. Don't forget to breathe. Sometimes I talk so much that I forget to breathe. Sometimes people focus really hard so they forget to breathe. All right, we'll do one more on each side. All right, so now we're gonna go into our last warm-up activity, which is calf raises. So what you're going to do is just stand with your feet underneath your hips. And if you need to hold on to a wall next to you, or maybe a sturdy counter or a sturdy chair, something that won't roll away or slip away, What you're going to do is you're just going to go onto your tippy toes and lift your heels up to the ceiling, and then you're going to drop your heels back down. And we're just going to repeat that. Let's do 15 times. So I've already done 30. That's 10. Awesome. So that was 15 for me, and that was our warm up. So now that we're warmed up, our body's ready, we got some blood flowing in our muscles, we are going to get started. So remember, in all things, not just dance or Zumba, but be kind to yourself, just because sometimes it is a little tricky to get moves down. Sometimes dancing is hard. I myself am not a dancer at heart, so I just like to have fun with it. So that's what I ask you to do today. So the three moves that we're going to do for our first song is what we'll focus on first. I encourage you to get a drink of water before we do that. I'm going to take a sip of water now. So there's three moves. The first one we've already done in our warm-ups. It's high knees. So remember, just a reminder, lift one knee up to the ceiling. So I'll lift my left knee up, my right arm comes forward, down, leg down and arm back, right knee up, left arm forward, right leg down and left arm back to the starting position. So high knees is what we're gonna do, and we're gonna do that for 8 counts. So each high knee is gonna be 1 count. So we'll end up doing 8 high knees, and we'll do 4 on each leg. So to count to 8, we'll do that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is 8 high knees. The next exercise that we're going to do is skater jumps. So what you're going to do is I'm going to step to the right of my exercise space so that I have space to go, because we are going to jump sideways. So I start on my right side of my exercise space, and then I lift up my left foot off the ground. So I'm on my right foot now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to leap to my side and land on my left foot. So when I do that, I'm going to bring my arms with me. So leaping onto my left foot. So I land on my left foot, and now my right foot is up in the air behind me. So when I said I bring my arms with me when I do that, what I meant is that my arms are just kind of flowing in the same direction that I'm going to move. So my arms are just hanging right now, a little bit to my left. When I jump to the right, I'm just going to sweep them across my body and point to the right, so that when I land on my right, they're pointed to my right. When I land on my left, they're pointed to my left. And that just helps with my momentum and balance. An alternative to skater jumps, maybe jumping is not so great for your balance. There isn't something super sturdy to hold on to when you're jumping that far sideways. You can just sidestep. So step from the right, step your foot to the right, bring your left foot over to meet your right foot, and then take your left foot, step over to the left, bring your right foot over to meet your left foot. So you'll just repeat that motion as an alternative to skater jumps. The third option, or the third exercise, is heel tap and reach. So what that is I will take my left foot, stick my heel out on the ground in front of me. So I just plant my heel, so my toes are to the sky, my heel is on the ground in front of me. And when I do that, I'm gonna reach my opposite hand up to the sky. So right heel is forward, left heel is forward, right hand is in the sky. Bring them back to starting position. Right heel is forward, left hand to the sky. Bring them back to starting position. So we will do that for 8 counts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And one thing I forgot to mention with the skater jumps is they take a little bit longer to get there. So by the time you leap, that's 2 counts. So we'll only do 4 skater jumps, 2 in each direction. So to throw that all together, we will just practice doing them all for 8 counts together, and then after we'll add music. So let's start with our high knees. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Skater jumps, get to the right side. Leap in 1, 2, leap again 3, 4, leap again 5, 6, leap again 7, 8, or if you're stepping. And then we go right into heel tap and reach. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then we'll go back to our high knees. So with that, we are now ready for music. So when the music is playing, you will still hear JoJo. She will tell you when to switch and which exercise to switch to. And if you're following along watching the video, I will also be demonstrating that. So with that, JoJo, we are ready for some music.
All right, let's do it. So our first song we're gonna start with is Hey Ya by Outkast. And we'll get started with high knees in 3, 2, 1, go.
1, 2, 3,
Yeah. Nice job, everyone.
Alrighty, so that was the end of our first song. So now we are going to jump right in to our second song. So feel free to take a sip of water. I'm going to. And three new moves. So the first move for song number two is ski jumps. So I'm going to be on my right side of my exercise space because again, we are going to jump sideways. So from 2 feet, I'm going to pretend that there, because I'm to my right side, I'm going to pretend there's an imaginary line to my left. Maybe I pretend that there's something spooky there, like a spider or a snake or something. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump over that to my left. So when I do that, I'm going to sink my hips low. And I'm going to, when I jump, I'm going to start with my fists behind my hips. When I jump forward, or when I jump to the side, my arms go forward. And then when I land with a bend in my knees and my arms go backwards. So jump, arms up, land, arms down. So I just jumped to the left. And then to repeat, I'm going to sink my hips back, bend my knees a little bit, start with my fists behind me, jump. When I jump, my arms go forward, and when I land, my arms go back. So jump, arms forward, and land, arms back. So that is ski jump. So we'll jump back and forth, overlap, imaginary, whatever you want it to be. We'll go with spider, jump over that imaginary spider. And that is ski jumps. The next one is similar to, actually exactly like, one of the moves that we did in the first round, the first song. It's gonna be that heel tap and reach. So I step forward with my left heel is on the ground, my left toes are to the sky, and I raise my right hand to the sky, bring them both back to the starting position, step forward with my right foot, my right heel's on the ground, with my left hand to the sky, then back forward. So we'll do that. And so with both of those, we'll do eight. So eight jumps, back and forth, eight heel taps. And then we will go into our third move, which is called sidestep. I know I get really creative with these names. For sidestep, I'm gonna start with my feet together in the middle of my exercise space. I'm gonna step my right foot out to my right side. And when I do that, I'm just gonna point my arms both to the right side. This is more of a dance type of move than an exercise one. So however you want to point your arms to the right, doesn't matter the form, as long as they're both going to the right. I'm gonna step my right foot back in, arms come to my sides, step my left foot out, point my arms to the left, bring my arms back into the middle. And we'll do eight steps. So stepping out, stepping out, stepping in. So we'll do that for eight counts as well. So to put it all together, I will start with ski jumps. And again, if ski jumps and jumping is too much, feel free to just step over that imaginary spider with one foot at a time. That is totally fine. So ski jumps, and we'll do that for a count of eight. Go right into the heel tap and reach for a count of eight, right into the sidestep. So ski jumps, ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, heel tap and reach. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and side step. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then we start back with ski jumps. So ski jumps, heel taps, and side steps. That's our three moves. And we are ready for music.
All right, let's do it. So we are going to start with ski jumps in 3, 2, 1, go.
I know that I'm running out of time. I want it all.
With heel tap and reach.
And I'm wishing they stop trying to turn me off. I want it all.
Switch, tricep.
And I'm walking on a wire, trying to go higher. I'm surrounded by clowns and liars. Even when I give it all away, I want it all.
Eliza.
Just like fire. And people like to laugh at you cause they are all the same.
See,
I would rather we just go a different way than play the game. And no matter the weather, we can do it better. You and me together forever and ever. We don't have to worry about a thing.
From the first exercise, you're going to start on the right side of your space, on your right foot, jump to the side, land on your left foot, and when you're doing that, you're so fluidly moving your arms into the direction, to point to the direction that you're moving. If jumping is a little bit too much, remember, stepping to the side works just as well. So that's skater jumps. And we do four skater jumps. Next one is side step. So we did that one in this last one. So side steps, what you're going to do, just as a review, start in the middle of your exercise space, take one step to the right with your right foot, keeping your left foot in the same spot, point your fingers and your hands over to the right, step your right foot back in, hands down by your sides. Step your left foot out and point to your left. And you just rotate. Step right, hands out. Step left, hands out. Step right, hands up. Step left, hands out. And then the last one is high knees. So we'll do 8 high knees. So just a reminder, lifting up your left knee, right arm comes forward, put both of them down, lift up your right knee, left arm comes forward, and both come down. So to do that with time, I will start with skater jumps on the right side of my exercise space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Side steps, step to my right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, seven, eight, and then high knees. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And that is our last sequence of moves that we do during the last song. So with that, we are ready for music.
All right, song number three coming right up. We're gonna start with skater jumps in 3, 2, 1, go.
Exercises that suit you better, please do. So I'm going to lay down on my belly. Once I'm on my belly, I'm going to put my hands underneath my shoulders. And I'm going to push up with my hands so that my shoulders and belly come off the ground, but my legs are still on the ground. And this is cobra. So we'll take a few breaths here, stretch it out. Alrighty, and then I'm gonna lower my hands down to the ground and I'm gonna roll onto my back. So I'm laying down on the ground on my back, feet are straight, flat, or legs are straight on the ground. My hands are down by my sides. What I'm going to do is I'm going to lift up my right knee, bend my right knee and bring it to my chest. To help bring it to my chest, I'm going to take both my hands, lace it behind my knee or my right thigh, and bring that closer to my chest. And if you want to while you're here, roll your ankles out. Your ankles did some work today, got some impact with lots of jumping in lateral directions. Alrighty, I'm gonna straighten my right knee, let it back down to the ground, but repeat on my left side. So bring my left knee to my chest, lace my fingers behind my left thigh and bring it in to meet my chest. If it doesn't reach your chest, that's fine. It doesn't reach my chest. Just pull it as close as it's comfortable. Alrighty. This next one, it's called lying twist. So I put my feet are flat on the ground and my knees are pointed to the ceiling. I'm still on the ground. I'm going to lift my feet up so the bottoms of my feet are facing the wall. And what I'm going to do is let my knees fall to my left side. And I put my arms out on a T flat on the ground. So I'm just twisting here. Feel it twist in my back. Lying twist. Alrighty, then I'll bring my knees back to the center. And then I'll lift my feet back up again so the bottoms of my feet are facing the wall in front of them, and then let my knees fall out to my right side, arms in a T on the ground. And this is a line twist on the other side. All right, when you're ready, come back to center. And then I'm gonna put my feet out or my legs out straight. I'm gonna actually sit up so my shoulders are and my back is off the ground now. And I'm going to do a seated fold, forward fold. So I'm gonna reach my hands to my toes. Some days I can get there, today is not one of those days. So if you can reach for your knees, that's great. If you can reach for your shins, that's what I'm doing. If you can reach and touch your toes, feel free to do that as well. Just take a few deep breaths here. Alrighty, and now the next stretch that we're gonna do is arm tricep stretch. So I'm gonna lift my left hand up to the sky. I'm gonna take the palm of my left hand and I'm gonna bend my left elbow. The palm of my left hand is gonna go behind my right shoulder. I'm gonna take my right hand, grab the outside of my left arm from behind and just pull my arm in towards the center of my body. Get that tricep stretch. Feels really good. And when you're ready, you can come out of that and switch. So to switch, I lift my right hand up to the sky. I bend my right elbow, so my right hand comes to the back of my left shoulder. I take my left hand, I bring it behind my body to grab the back of my right arm. And pull it towards the left side of my body. Lots of lefts and rights. I'm doing a little swaying because I have one of the three songs stuck in my head now, as I will probably for the next month. The last stretch that we're going to do is the butterfly stretch. So I'm sitting down still, and what I'm going to do is bring the bottoms of my feet together so that they're touching, and let my knees fall out to the sides. So this stretch can be deepened or lessened if you bring your feet away from your body and your knees pointing up higher. And you can deepen the stretch by bringing your feet in closer to the center of your body and letting your knees fall out to the side. Everyone has different flexibility, so it's definitely a deep stretch. So do only what you're comfortable doing. And I've been doing this stretch a lot lately with all the videos that we're making. And I used to not be able to have my knees pointed all the way up to my right and left, but now I can. So practice really does help improve performance. And again, if you want to repeat any of these stretches, if you want to replace them with any stretches that you like to do, feel free to do that. Feel free to pause, stay in the stretches for longer. But we are concluding this lesson for today. So thank you so much for joining. I appreciate you being with us. Jojo, you have anything to add?
I hope everyone had a great time doing some Zumba, and we look forward to seeing how many views we get.
Awesome. Thanks,
all right, everyone. Thanks for joining, everyone.